We're here in a typical Hot Springs neighborhood, and going on behind us is part of what is referred to as manhole rehabilitation phases 3 and 4. And with me today is Larry Merriman, the project manager for the city's engineering department. And Larry's going to help explain to us what manhole rehabilitation is all about.
Well, manhole rehabilitation, for most parts, consists of applying a coating after we've gone back and reestablished structural integrity and done seals. What you see behind you is very, very typical for us. That is replacing the frame, ring, and cover. And that is because when these were originally installed, and be it in paved or non-paved, and in this case we're in someone's yard, in the non-paved areas, what happens is that ring actually begins to trap the water that surrounds it as it flows through the yard, and it allows it to get into our system, and we end up treating the I&I, the inflow and infiltration issue. So as part of our consent administrative order, we have addressed our manholes throughout our system. This was almost a $3.4 million effort last year. This year we're investing $2.2 million, and we have TG Excavating out of Catoosa, Oklahoma, doing the work for us. The design was by RJN, again, one of our engineering partners, frequently mentioned as we partner with them a lot. And this is one of the, according to the standards within the industry, one of the highest statistics for inflow and infiltration are your manholes. With 12,000 in our system, it's important that we address this. I know that previously we had touted some great results from phases 1 and 2, and we expect to hopefully achieve those same numbers in this phase 3 and 4.
Now, what were phase 1 and 2 all about, Larry?
Phase 1 and 2 dealt with essentially the same scope of work, prioritized as phase 1 and 2 simply based on flow testing we did that identified and defined the regions and particular manholes that were in the worst shape. We replaced over 600, we addressed over 2,300 manholes. This time we're only going to be replacing about 36, and then we'll be addressing somewhere in the neighborhood of 600 to 800. It varies depending upon what we find in the field.
And you were talking about sealing manholes. Mm-hmm. That was done prior to this type of work, right?
Correct. We actually, as you go through and seal the top, at some point, depending upon what the manhole inspection revealed as far as defects, we'll come back, we'll put epoxy coating sometimes, we'll reapply the cementitious coating. We do several different methods within the manhole rehabilitation.
Well, most people know what a manhole is and what it does, but I think few people understand that it takes maintenance and repair.
It does, just like everything else, and unfortunately we tend to neglect them if we don't see them, and that's not something most people actually go around looking for.
So this phase 3 and 4, mm-hmm, encompasses quite a few manholes. You said 60?
No, at least.
Yes.
Yes.
In the neighborhood of 60 manholes for these
Correct.
Phases. Okay. How long will it take to complete these phases?
We actually had this scheduled out into June of 2015. And, I said earlier the 600 to 800, if you count all of the different applications for repair and rehabilitation, it's actually more along the line of 1,500.
I see. Because these folks are very efficient behind us. They'll get quite a few manholes done in one day.
Yes. These guys, one particular crew like this, it's not uncommon for them to get 8 to 10 of these a day. And again, as you'll note, we have all of the proper gear here. They have tripod and air sampling equipment. As you're entering this is a confined space. So as always, safety is a concern. And then you'll see them take the extra effort of putting poly or plastic down on the folks' yard so that we don't scatter rock, mud, and other things. And then when they finish, it literally looks like we weren't here.
So very little environmental impact after
very
the job is wrapped up.
We try to be non-intrusive to all involved.
Excellent. And you described the big picture, that this is all part of the city's proactive efforts to meet the consent administrative order.
Yes. Yes, this is a bond-funded project, again, out of our 2013 bond, the $40 million that, again, we've been entrusted to administer in a manner that yields great results.
And what is the price tag of this project?
This project is actually $2.2 million.
So quite a bit of scope here.
Yes, a lot of work.
Is there anything else that you want to add as we wrap up here?
No, only that we encourage the public to always offer feedback. If you think we've done a job well and you want to tell us, we'd appreciate that. If, however, we fail to meet your standards or expectations, feel free to call me and let me know and we'll address it.
Right, and Larry can be reached at what number?
501-321-6801.
I think the folks in this neighborhood are well aware of what is going on. They've been apprised of you know, of the project and the benefits thereof. But if you do have any questions as the city proceeds through other neighborhoods, you know, please don't hesitate to give Larry or this or any of us in the city of Hot Springs a call. We'll make sure that we route it right to him. Thank you, Larry, and next week we'll join you with more City News. Thanks.